Hello students, today we are going to study the next method of preparation of alkyl halide, that is from hydrocarbons. We know that there are four types of hydrocarbons. One is alkane, first one is alkane, second one is alkenes, third one is alkynes, and last one, that is fourth one, is aromatic. Here in the previous standard we study the preparation of alkyl halides by using alkanes. And we know that when alkanes are converted into alkyl halides, then this type of reaction known as substitution reaction, or this conversion is done by substitution reactions. Simply, in that reactions, simply we replace one hydrogen of alkane by using one halogen, and that alkane converted into alkyl halide. Simple replacement of hydrogen by using halogen. So that's reaction called as substitution reactions. Now we also prepared alkyl halides by using unsaturated hydrocarbons, especially alkenes, that is carbon-carbon double bonds. And when alkenes are converted into alkyl halides, this follows addition reaction. This follows addition reaction. Here, simply in this reaction, simply hydrogen halide is added across the carbon-carbon double bond, and that carbon-carbon double bond by addition of hydrogen halide gets converted into carbon-carbon single bond and gives a product, alkyl halide. So this is the addition reaction, and this addition reaction we study here in 12th standard. So we start the reaction by using which we prepared alkyl halides from hydrocarbons. Alkyl halides are formed from saturated, that is alkanes, as well as unsaturated hydrocarbons, that is alkenes. This preparation by using alkanes we already study in previous standard. Now we study preparation by using alkenes. First, addition of hydrogen halide to alkenes. आता आपल्याला बघायचे addition of hydrogen halide to alkenes. This reaction called as addition reaction. Alkyl halides are formed on addition of HX to alkenes. This addition of HX to alkenes take place in two ways, according to Markovnikov's rule and anti-Markovnikov's rule. First of all, we know about the alkenes. There are two types of alkenes. two types of alkenes. First is symmetrical alkene. First is symmetrical alkenes, and second one is unsymmetrical alkene. The basic difference between these two alkenes is that when the similar groups are attached to the both side of carbon-carbon double bond, then these type of alkenes called as symmetrical alkenes. And when different types of alkyl groups are attached to both side of carbon-carbon double bond, called as unsymmetrical alkene. Called as unsymmetrical alkene. When we add HX to this symmetrical alkene, then this gives same product. Here, these two additions are considered only unsymmetrical alkenes, not unsymmetrical alkenes. Both types of alkenes here, symmetrical and unsymmetrical. Because symmetrical alkenes form only one product. Here, it is clearly mentioned that symmetrical alkene by the addition of hydrogen halide gives same product. When either maybe halide as added to both of any one carbon, it gives same product. But when we add hydrogen halide to unsymmetrical alkene, it gives different products. And these two types of different products are forms according to two different rules called as Markovnikov's rule and anti-Markovnikov's rule. Now we see the addition on both types of alkenes, that is symmetrical alkenes and unsymmetrical alkenes. First, addition of HX to symmetrical alkenes. When HX are added to symmetrical alkenes, then they forms only one type of product. For example, first we take the general reaction RCH double bond CHR, and when HX is added to this, here this negative part of reagent, that is X halide, is may either be added to this carbon or this carbon. That gives only one type of product because this alkene is symmetrical alkene. And due to the symmetrical nature, it gives only one type of alkyl halide, that is RCH2CHXR. Example, we take the example CH2 double bond CH2. The basic example of symmetrical alkene is ethene. And when the HCl is added to this ethene, then this chlorine may be added to either on this carbon or this carbon. It gives similar product. For that is CH3, CH2, Cl, or Cl, CH2, CH3. both are same, these both products are same, and these are ethyl chloride. You should be noted that when addition reaction take place, then unsaturated hydrocarbons or unsaturated compounds converted into saturated compounds, that is carbon-carbon double bond converted into carbon-carbon single bond. Now go to the next type of addition, that is addition of HX on unsymmetrical alkenes. We already know about unsymmetrical alkene. In this unsymmetrical alkene, the both alkyl groups attached to the carbon-carbon double bond are different. Now, let us see the statement. When HX are added to unsymmetrical alkenes, they form two types of products according to two different rules called, that first rule called Markovnikov's rule, and second one rule called as anti-Markovnikov's rule. Okay, in detail we study both rules. First, for the consideration, we take example this is an unsymmetrical alkene, and when this reagent HBr is added to this unsymmetrical alkene, that is prop1-in. IUPAC name of this alkene is prop1-in. This is unsymmetrical because both of these doubly bonded carbon carries different groups. Here this carbon carry two hydrogen and this carbon carry one CH3 group and one hydrogen, hence it is unsymmetrical alkene. Now when this HBr unsymmetrical reagent is added to this unsymmetrical alkene, there are two products formed according to two different path A and path B. There are two possibility of addition of this negative part across the carbon-carbon double bond. The one part is that this Br should be added to this carbon and forms product like this is 2-bromopropane, and according to B part, this negative part of reagent, that is Br, should be added to this carbon CH2 carbon and forms product like this CH3 CH2 CH2 Br. That is 1-bromopropane. Now here two products are formed, and one of which is formed according to Markovnikov's rule and anti-Markovnikov's rule. First, for the identification of both products, let us see the statement of Markovnikov's rule. The Markovnikov's rule states as when we take the unsymmetrical reagent and this unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene, then the negative part of that unsymmetrical reagent is added to or attached to the carbon atom of carbon-carbon double bond which carries less number of hydrogen atom, or in other word, the carbon atom which having more number of alkyl groups. Here this is the statement of Markovnikov's rule. When an unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene, the negative part, that is X halide, of reagent gets attached to the carbon atom of carbon-carbon double bond. Carbon atom of carbon-carbon double bond, which carries less number of hydrogen atom or more number of alkyl groups. Now, for the illustration of this Markovnikov's rule, it turns towards the example or reaction. Here, these are the carbons which carries carbon-carbon double bond. Now, this is the carbon which carries less number of hydrogen atom, or in other words, carries more number of alkyl groups. So, according to Markovnikov's rule, this negative part Br of unsymmetrical reagent definitely added to or attached to this carbon, CH carbon, and gives the more substituted product or alkane by addition, means A, the product formed by path A, that is 2-bromopropane, and this product is major according to Markovnikov's rule. According to Markovnikov's rule, and this product formed by the path B is minor according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. Now, we see what is anti-Markovnikov's rule. Anti-Markovnikov's rule is exactly opposite to the Markovnikov's rule. Now, let us see the statement of anti-Markovnikov's rule. When an unsymmetrical reagent like HBr is added to an unsymmetrical alkene in the presence of peroxide, you must be noted this, in the presence of peroxide, in the statement of Markovnikov's rule, there is no mention of any peroxide or any other extra effort or any other extra factor, but here peroxide is mentioned. Then the negative part of reagent, that is Br, gets attached to the carbon atom of carbon-carbon double bond which carries more number of hydrogen atom, or in the other words, less number of alkyl groups. Means again it turns towards the previous reaction. This here, this carbon carries more number of hydrogen atoms and less number of alkyl groups, B carbon. Means when this Br minus, negative part added to this carbon, that is CH2 carbon, it forms this product according to path B. But there must be presence of peroxide. When there is no peroxide added to the reaction, then that follows the Markovnikov's rule, but not anti-Markovnikov's rule. It is must. And only HBr shows the anti-Markovnikov's rule. Only HBr, not HCl and HI. Only HBr shows the Markovnikov's rule. So, according to only HBr shows the anti-Markovnikov's rule. HCl and HI does not show anti-Markovnikov's rule. Here, the product, this product formed by path A, this is minor product formed according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. But here, the product formed by path B in the presence of peroxide from this, it is major. It is major according to anti-Markovnikov's rule. Okay, here this is minor according to Markovnikov's rule, but major according to anti-Markovnikov's rule, present in the presence of peroxide. This effect is exactly opposite to the Markovnikov's rule, hence called as anti-Markovnikov's rule. We must be noted that Markovnikov's rule, this Markovnikov's rule done in the absence of peroxide, absence of peroxide and shown by all, that is HCl, HBr and HI, but this anti-Markovnikov rule is done in the presence of peroxide, presence of peroxide and only HBr shows this anti-Markovnikov's rule, not HCl and HI, only HBr. This effect is take place in the presence of peroxide, hence it is also called as peroxide effect. This effect is take place in the presence of peroxide, hence also called as peroxide effect. In 1933, M.S. Karash and F.R. Mayo discovered this effect, hence it is also called as Karash-Mayo effect. The peroxide has no effect on addition of HCl and HBr, hence HBr, only HBr shows peroxide effect. Means here, this peroxide has no effect on addition of HCl and HI. Peroxide जो असतो तो एच आय आणि एच सी एलवरती कोण एच सी एलच्या ॲडिशनवरती कोणत्याही प्रकारचे इफेक्ट करत नाही. ओनली एच बी आर शोज द परॉक्साईड इफेक्ट. ओनली दिस परॉक्साईड इफेक्ट द ॲडिशन ऑफ एच बी आर. दिस परॉक्साईड ओनली इफेक्ट द ॲडिशन ऑफ एच बी आर टू अल्किन. हेन्स इट एच बी आर शोज परॉक्साईड इफेक्ट. अँड दिस परॉक्साईड इफेक्ट इज or addition of HBr by using peroxide to alkene take place according to the free radical mechanism.